Welcome to First Presbyterian Church of Glasgow, Kentucky. It's a true delight to have you worship with us today. If you're viewing this service for the first time, we give you a special welcome today. It's always a pleasure to extend welcome to new friends, new faces. So I take delight in saying welcome to all for this hour of worship this morning. Announcements to call to your attention before we begin are these. Today is April 26, 2020, and is our third Sunday in the season of Easter. Easter is a season, not just one day. So we'll continue forth through today and next month in the season of Eastertide. So we do want to recognize this is our third Sunday in the season of Easter. I also want to point out to you that if you're watching us, and I'm sure you are, on our YouTube channel, if you have not yet subscribed to that channel, please do so if you can. The more subscribers we have, the easier our channel is to find when people do a search for us online. So it does make a difference. Please subscribe to our channel if you've not already done so. And also, we want you to enjoy the content on our channel. We have many videos on our channel from our String Academy Winter Recital, many youth playing the cello, violin, in solo, duets, trios. Watch those videos. Enjoy them. We have very talented youth in our Academy of Strings, and those videos are posted for your viewing and for your content. And so with that, I do, again, welcome all to our worship service. I do trust that each of us watching this service will sense the presence of God this hour of worship together. Let us worship God together.
This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. Greater love has no person than this, that a person lay down their life for a friend. You are my friends if you do what I command. No longer do I call you servants, for the servant does not know what his master is doing. But I have called you friends, for that I have heard from my Father, I have made known to you. You did not choose me, but I chose you and appointed you that you should go and bear fruit, and that your fruit should abide, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give it to you. This I command you, to love one another.
People of prayer, we're called to be ones that lift up one another in prayer. We do know that the world is very equipped at giving us bad news and difficult situations to face, including the one we're in now with social distancing and efforts to combat COVID-19. This is a trying time for us, but God is still present and God is still at work. And we're still receiving good things from God's hands. So we're going to come to prayer now and to give God what's on our hearts and minds, give to God our thanksgivings and our concerns. On our birthday list this week, we only have one birthday to announce, but it's a doozy. Tomorrow is the birthday of Meredith Evans. She is having her birthday tomorrow on Monday. So we do recognize her birthday and wish her happy birthday tomorrow. So with that in mind, I ask you now to please join me in prayer. Let's give to God the joys and the concerns of our hearts, and we'll conclude our time with the Lord's Prayer. Let's pray together. Loving God, we thank you today for, again, a chance to worship you, to praise your name, to be in your presence. It's a blessing to us to have the technology to be able to sit where we are right now and be a part of this worship service together as a church family. We ask that you continue to bless the efforts of not just this church, but the whole community of faith to reach out to the world around us in times of social distancing, that you bless the efforts of churches all over the land to be ones that send your message out in new and innovative and creative ways. We know, Lord God, that you'll bless efforts to proclaim the gospel. You'll bless efforts to further our connections with our fellow members of humanity around the globe. And we also know full well that you'll be with us in our times of trial and need. We today ask that you be with our prayer list. We pray for those that we have been lifting up for quite a while. We lift up Eleanor and Georgia Lou and Linda. We pray for our recent additions to our prayer list, Vern's sister Margaret, the family of Jack Leach. We pray for those around us that have been affected by COVID-19 and social distancing. We ask, Lord God, that you be with these concerns of ours, that we know our prayers will make a difference in their lives. And as people of prayer, we also give you many thanks, many joys, many words of affirmation for what you've done for us. We thank you for the birthdays this week, for Meredith's birthday Monday. We thank you also for the work of the leadership team of this church, for the efforts they have been putting in behind the scenes to ensure that the gospel message still is heard loud and clear. We thank you today for Jackson and Leisha and Chadwick and Morgan. But today, as every day, we thank you most of all for the greatest gift you've ever given us, the gift of your Son, Jesus Christ, indeed a true friend to us, a true friend in which we're building memories with, a true friend that has taught us to pray this way: Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. We start this week's message here at King's Cafe. This is a coffee shop just around the corner from our church building, a place that we frequent as a church staff. I'm here because it reminds me of a place, and it is a place, where a lot of people come and gather. I know there's a local group of ministers that meet here once a week, every week, and talk about services and their churches. This also is a great place where friends gather around. They come here just to slow down a bit, to take a break from their routine, to come here and share some stories with one another. A great spot for that. Now, we know that because of social distancing, the cafe here is quieter than usual, but we know also that one day real soon, this place will return to be that hub in the local community where ministers and other local folks come here. They come here to slow down, to sit at the table, to share a cup of coffee, to talk about their life with one another, to share stories. This is a true gathering place for those that work and live around King's Cafe. This place reminds me, though, of an account that happened in the Gospels where three friends got together for a very wonderful time of friendship and storytelling. Three friends that gathered together, not in a coffee shop, but they gathered together on a long walk to a nearby town. The three friends we're going to talk about today are Jesus is one friend, and his two other friends, a guy named Cleopas, a disciple and friend of his. And the third friend is a fellow that, unfortunately, we've lost his name to history. We don't know what his name is. And so, for today's purposes, I'm going to take the liberty of giving him a name for today. And today, I'm going to call our nameless friend, I'm going to call him Fred. And I guarantee you, Fred is not his real name. I know that. But today, he is Fred. And so, we're going to hear a story today about three friends, Cleopas, Fred, disciples of Jesus, and Jesus himself as they gather together, not in a coffee shop, but on a walk on a road to Emmaus, where they shared stories and had a wonderful experience. Today's gospel lesson is the very famous passage, the road to Emmaus. We're going to join Jesus, Cleopas, and Fred on that journey. And today I'm glad to say that today's reading of the gospel lesson will be read by Mr. Ambassador. So, Jackson, take it away, please.
I would be happy to, Reverend Evans. Starting on Luke chapter 24, verse 13. That very day, two of them were going to a village named Emmaus, about 7 miles from Jerusalem, and talking with each other about all these things that had happened. While they were talking and discussing together, Jesus himself drew near and went with them, but their eyes were kept from recognizing him. And he said to them, "What is this conversation which you are holding with each other as you walk?" And they stood still, looking sad. Then one of them, named Cleopas, answered him, "Are you the only visitor to Jerusalem who does not know the things that have happened here in these days?" And he said to them, "What things?" And they said to him, "Concerning Jesus of Nazareth, who was a prophet mighty in deed and word before God and all the people, and how the chief priests and rulers delivered him up to be condemned to death and crucified him. But we had hoped that he was the one to redeem Israel. Yes, and besides all of this, it is now the third day since this has happened."
Well, as Jackson read there in the gospel lesson, on the day of Easter, on Resurrection Day, Cleopas and Fred leave Jerusalem and begin their 7-mile walk to Emmaus. Well, as they begin that walk, Jesus joins them on that walk. Now, Cleopas and Fred know Jesus very well. They're friends of his, but they did not recognize Jesus when he joined them and began walking with them. And so Jesus, when he joins Cleopas and Fred, he asks them, "Hey guys, how's it going?" basically. And so Cleopas and Fred said, "What do you mean, how's it going? Don't you not know what happened in this town this past week?" And Jesus says to them, "You know, what happened?" And so Cleopas and Fred then begin to tell Jesus a story about Palm Sunday, about the sham trial, about the crucifixion, about all of that. And they begin this walk, this 7-mile walk to Emmaus, beginning their conversation. They slow down. They spent time together, and they started a conversation that would change the lives of Cleopas and Fred forever. Now, to tell us more about this conversation, Jackson, please continue the gospel lesson.
"Moreover, some women of our company amazed us. They were at the tomb early in the morning and did not find his body. And they came back saying that they had even seen a vision of angels who said that he was alive. Some of those who were with us went to the tomb and found it just as the women had said, but him they did not see. And he said to them, 'O foolish men, and slow of heart to believe that the prophets had spoken. Was it not necessary that the Christ should suffer these things and enter into his glory?' And beginning with Moses and all the prophets, he interpreted to them in all the scriptures the things concerning himself."
Well, here we are at this cove on Barren River Lake. This cove we selected because it is, according to Google Maps anyway, exactly 7 miles from our church. The cove we're at here to our church is the same distance that Jesus, Cleopas, and Fred walked on that road. And so now 7 miles as the crow flies, not 7 miles on the road. But we're here to illustrate the kind of distance, the kind of travel time that Jesus, Cleopas, and Fred would have had as they took this walk to Emmaus. Now, on the walk to Emmaus, Cleopas and Fred start out sort of depressed. They're down in the dumps a bit because of what happened to Jesus. And as they said, as we heard read to us, they were mystified because the first Easter morning, Mary Magdalene went to the tomb and it was empty, and that mystified them. They didn't know what to think of that. And so Jesus begins to talk to them on that 7-mile trip. Jesus tells them, "Oh guys, you know better than this." Well, in fact, we'll see what Jesus says exactly. Jesus says to Cleopas and Fred, as they are mystified about what happened, Jesus says to them, "Oh foolish men, and slow of heart to believe." And then Jesus began to teach them and tell them all about himself. And remember, they don't know it's Jesus, but he tells them all about himself and the good news of the gospel. In fact, Jesus goes back to Moses, starts at Moses, and tells Cleopas and Fred all about the scriptures and how they pertain to Jesus, about his ministry, about the good news of the gospel. And you know, as Cleopas and Fred are hearing Jesus tell this on this nice, slow 7-mile walk, Cleopas and Fred were taken down memory lane. They remember these things Jesus was talking about because they were there. They saw miracles. They heard the teaching and the preaching of Jesus. They were remembering what Jesus was talking about. And so after 7 miles of listening to Jesus refresh their memory about his ministry, they finally get to their destination. They made the 7-mile journey to Emmaus. And here we'll hear the end of our gospel lesson. Jackson, please finish it for us.
So they drew near the village to which they were going. He appeared to be going further, but they constrained him, saying, "Stay with us, for it is toward the evening, and the day is now far spent." So he went in to stay with them. When he was at the table with them, he took the bread and blessed and broke it and gave it to them. And their eyes were opened and they recognized him, and he vanished out of their sight. They said to each other, "Did not our hearts burn within us while he talked to us on the road, while he opened up the scriptures?" And they rose that same hour and returned to Jerusalem. And they found the 11 gathered together and those who were with them, who said, "The Lord has risen indeed and has appeared to Simon." Then they told what had happened on the road and how he was known to them in breaking of the bread. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Well, as Jackson finished our gospel lesson, we ended the trip in Emmaus, the 7-mile walk. And so back here in our sanctuary, we're going to finish out the story from here. When they got to Emmaus, Cleopas and Fred got to their destination. They were at the home they were going to, and Jesus acted like he wanted to keep walking. And so Cleopas and Fred said, "No way, you're going to come home with us. You're going to come into our house." And so Jesus, Fred, and Cleopas enter the house. Now in that house was a table, and on that table were the same items on every table in that region. On that table were wine, bread, olive oil, figs, right? Every table had the same thing. And so as Fred, Jesus, and Cleopas sit down to have a drink and have some bread, nourishment, as soon as Jesus picked up the elements, the wine and the bread, and broke that bread, in that moment, they recognized Jesus for who he was. That's Jesus. And as soon as they saw it was Jesus, he disappeared, all right? So right then, Cleopas and Fred had a memory that would never be taken from them. In fact, on that whole walk from Jerusalem to Emmaus, Jesus refreshed their memory on a lot of other things that Cleopas and Fred and Jesus had done together. And right then, if you remember the reading, Cleopas and Fred said, "You know, when Jesus was telling us about the ministry, they said, weren't our hearts just burning inside of us?" Their hearts were burning inside of them in joy, in excitement, and in love. And in that moment at that table, Cleopas and Fred enjoyed a memory that was theirs forever. And I guarantee you, as they got to be older men and went on in their life, they probably told that story of the walk to Emmaus at least once a day. And I bet you, every time Cleopas and Fred told that story again, their hearts burned within them again. The event was in the past, but the experience and the memory was theirs to have that day. And I guarantee you this as well, if we could somehow pull the veil back between us and heaven and take a peek inside heaven right now and see where Cleopas and Fred are right now, guarantee you in heaven, Cleopas and Fred are still living that memory, telling that story of the road to Emmaus. And even where they are right now, their hearts still burn inside them in joy and excitement when they tell that story. The event is well in the past, but the experience and the memory is theirs even today. And that's our lesson for today from the gospel lesson. That's one of the many lessons we can get from the road to Emmaus. The lesson today we're going to focus on is that each of us, by God's design, just like Cleopas and Fred, we have also wonderful, loving memories of things in the past. And even though they're in the past, that experience is still ours today. Our hearts also still burn. And in fact, the experiences we have in the past, those memories are ours for eternity. That's God's gift to us this Easter season. That's our Easter gift that God gives to all of us, that in God's wisdom, in God's creation, God's design, He made us people that can have amazing experiences with friends of ours whom we care so much for. By God's design, we're able to have amazing experiences with some amazing family, right, in our lives. And when we have these amazing experiences with our loved ones, our friends, and our family, just like Fred and Cleopas, our hearts also burn within us, right? The love, the enjoyment, the appreciation, our hearts also burn inside of us. And as we go forward with the memories of times that may have gone by, we still have today the burning heart, the joy, the memory, the experience. We can enjoy it again and again and again. In fact, those moments we can enjoy for eternity. Now, I just want to pause a minute to change the subject. I'm here with my good friend Chadwick. And I was at home this week, Chadwick, and Meredith was watching The Wizard of Oz, which I had not seen The Wizard of Oz in probably 3 or 4 years or 5 years.
We love it. Watch it every year.
Every year? It's a tradition in your home?
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Well, it should be in mine, too, because once I started watching it, I couldn't get away from it. It kind of just pulls you in, you know, from the beginning. And the music is something in that that really, you know, pulls me in. When it first goes, remember when it first goes from the black and white film to the Technicolor, and all those colors light up, and they're in Munchkin Land. That's really
the land. Yes, the land.
Amazing
of
thing, amazing thing. So we watched part of that, and I know that you know it very well. Probably better if it's an annual tradition in your home. You know it better.
We know all the music, all the music for sure.
Play a piece from that strikes you, if you don't mind. Each character had their own need, right? So the scarecrow needed the brain.
Their own story to that same tune.
That's right, the same music to each. And so the Tin Man sang about the heart, same music.
Mm-hmm.
And when the
lion sang about his courage or lack thereof.
Music, right? Uh-huh. Yeah. You know, when I was watching that with Meredith, they were terrified of the Oz. They thought he was a big man that was scary, but the truth was he mm-hmm. wasn't quite so scary after all. He was behind that curtain. You know, at the end, he was all right guy, wasn't he? Mm-hmm. He did good things for them. I didn't watch the end of it. Did Dorothy ever finally get back? She got back to Kansas, but was it in the balloon or was it through? I couldn't remember.
She woke up in her bed at home.
The slippers got her back somehow, or she clicked her heels?
She clicked her heels, and the next thing she knew, she was at home.
Back at home.
Woke up at home with Auntie M.
I didn't see the very end of it. Uh-huh. I got called away. But toward the end, I saw this one scene when Meredith was watching it. It's when the Wizard of Oz gave the Tin Man his heart, right? Mm-hmm. You recall what the heart, it wasn't an actual heart. It was a clock kind of thing. And the Wizard of Oz told the Tin Man something. I wrote it down, actually, when I heard it.
Okay.
The Wizard of Oz told the Tin Man, when he gave him the heart, the Wizard of Oz said, "Remember, Tin Man, a heart is not judged by how much you love, but by how much you are loved by others." Mm-hmm. I thought, that's a good quote. And it caught my attention because it reminds me about the message of Emmaus today, of what Cleopas and Fred went through. The Wizard of Oz was onto something. And that's a truth that we love others, no doubt. Our friends, our family. And just as importantly, they love us, right? We receive love from them. And beautiful things happen when we love others and they love us. Beautiful events happen. Times in our life that are just so amazing to us, we'll never forget them. And the beauty of the gospel lesson is a reminder of God's gift to us, that these memories we have with our loved ones, our family, and our friends, they're theirs, they're ours to enjoy in the moment, and theirs too to enjoy in the moment. But the beauty is, those events are also ours to enjoy in the present, and also ours to enjoy tomorrow, and also ours to enjoy next year. In fact, those events, those memories, those experiences, those things that make our heart burn with inside of us are ours to enjoy for eternity. Yes, many years ago, Cleopas and Fred, as I called them this whole time, and Jesus sat at a table and shared wine and bread with one another. And there a memory was created. We're still talking about today. Today, we go into the world and give thanks to God that we're created in such a way that we have the same experience in our lives, that we as people of God, through our faith, and through the lesson of Jesus Christ we read about today, we too have those same experiences in our lives. Amazing events. And give thanks to God today that those just don't stay in the past. Those events are ours today. They're ours to enjoy tomorrow. They still burn our heart inside of us. And they'll burn our heart inside of us even when we come to the next life to live. And for that blessing today, for that great gift of God, we give thanks.
Here's to the ones that we've got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. The drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way, 'cause the drinks bring back all the memories. Memories bring back memories. bring back you. There's a time that I remember when I didn't know pain, when I believed in forever and everything would stay the same. Now my heart feels like December when somebody says your name, 'cause I can't reach out to call you, but I know I will someday. Everybody hurts sometime, everybody hurts someday. Everything will be alright, I'm gonna raise the glass and say, here's to the ones that we've got. Cheers to the wish you were here but you're not, 'cause the drinks bring back the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today, toast to the ones we lost on the way, 'cause the drinks bring back the memories bring back, memories bring back you.
Friends, please join me in a closing prayer to this message. We thank you, Lord God, that just like Cleopas and Fred discovered with their dear, dear friend Jesus, that you are a God that blesses us with incredible moments throughout the days of our lives. And we're also so thankful that we have with us, when those events do happen, they don't just depart from us, no. We have the memory of all of those still in our hearts. And it's those memories of those experiences with those whom we love that even to this day still burns our hearts within us. And for that blessing and gift that you give, we give you thanks today. In Jesus' name, amen. We thank you for taking time this morning to join us in worship. Wherever you're viewing, your presence is a blessing. I can tell you that your participation is felt by the power of the Holy Spirit among us that have put this service together. Also know that the needs of the church continue on as well, that as a church, the efforts to bring these services and do the ministry of Jesus Christ in the world is a ministry that continues forth and requires support. As you go through your days, I encourage you to consider your ability to give to this church to continue this ministry going forward. We are blessed by God with so much, and God only expects just a small portion back in return. Our website has a Give Now button to pay electronically. Our YouTube channel also has that ability to accept electronic payment. Checks can be mailed to the church, 200 East Washington Street, Glasgow, Kentucky, 42141. Without you and your support, none of this is possible. Please consider this church as you consider your willingness to give back to God the portion from which God has given to you. And so with that, I encourage you all to have a blessed day, to go out and to enjoy the memories you've been blessed with. Those events that are in the past, but which joy and love and the burning of your heart continues today and forever. Now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with each of you this day and always.